because up until that moment I thought I'd been done a great job, you know, for her. But at that moment I wasn't sure. Really, from that time, I didn't want to get involved in anything which was short-term type thing. I wanted to get involved in and try and help people build long-term careers.
With artist development now at the forefront of his mind, it was recommended to Blackwell that he check out a rhythm and blues band at a small club in Birmingham.
Walking up the stairs, I heard this voice, you know, and I really couldn't believe it. It sounded like Ray Charles on helium.
I walk that walk!
And I couldn't wait to get up there and see what was there. And then when I got up, there they were, you know, and it was Steve Winwood, Muff, Spencer Davis, and Peter York.
I got my eyes on you.
I think what excited him about the Spencer Davis group was here was a white group like him who loved its black music in all forms, and through Steve Winwood could sing it pretty close to the bone.
At the time I met them, I said right after them, I'd love to record them.
At this stage, Ireland was just an importer of Jamaican ska music. That was purely and utterly his market. He couldn't guarantee us a record deal. He wanted to manage us, and then he would find us a record deal once he'd managed us. One or two of us were unsure, but he unquestionably had a vision and he had a determination and he knew where he wanted to go. So we agreed to work with him.
Chris called me up and played a demo over the phone, and it was Jackie. A Bluebeat-ish version of Keep On Running, and I thought, oh yeah, I like them.
Keep on running, keep on running.
Very ska sound, and we thought it had a great chorus, so we decided we'd make it into a more R&B kind of song, and we all thought it was the kind of record that could be a big hit single for us, and all of a sudden, the meeting with Jackie Edwards had sparked it.
What really gave it its rock thing was putting in the fuzz guitar.
We'd obviously been influenced by Keith, you know, Satisfaction, so that fitted right on there.
Keep on running. Keep on hiding. One fine day I'm gonna be the one.
If you listen to that record today, Steve's voice, it's, you know, it's a great interpretation of a very good song.
Like Millie Small before, it was decided that Ireland was still too small to distribute mainstream pop music, and the band were licensed to the Fontana label. It proved to be a wise decision, as Keep On Running supplanted the biggest band in the world at number one.
People say, what was it like replacing the Beatles at the top of the charts? Because we can work it out that Day Trip was number one at the time. I remember Paul congratulating us when we got to number one. He goes, number one, you know, because we just beat them.
The Spencer Davis group continued their success with three more major hits. Blackwell, quick to preempt musical trends, saw it was time for a major change in strategy.
After Spencer Davis group had their big hit, Keep On Running, which was 1966, then I really started to focus most of my time on rock music and left Jamaican music behind and let our involvement in that more be just handled by our interest in Trojan.
The newly formed Trojan label was now Ireland's outlet for Jamaican music, including the new reggae sound which had evolved from ska. Blackwell's move into rock music coincided with album sales outweighing the single. Long-term artist development continued to be central to the Island Records ethos. The problem now was one of perception.
How was I going to get over the fact that Ireland was known for Jamaican music? And so I thought, what I'm going to do is make the color of the label pink. So clearly, that's a vast change. There's nothing pink about any Jamaican music.
Kicking sand from beach to beach.
Steve Winwood, having left the Spencer Davis Group to expand his musical horizons, formed a new band, Traffic. Their debut single was the first on the newly formed Pink label.
Traffic were closer to a kind of jazz-ish type band in a way. They came up with a totally original sound. I loved what they were doing.
I think Traffic, was the basis. It was the start of Island Records proper.
What followed was a huge period of expansion for Island Records.
A proper record company has to have a studio.
A studio was opened in Basing Street, London, to give signings extended recording time.
You weren't paying studio rates, running up huge bills, so there was more latitude in terms of what you could do as a producer.
Muff Winwood was brought in as the label's first A&R man to increase the roster.
All we needed to do was make sure it was music of the highest quality. That was Blackwell's dictum, but we all believed in it and ran with it.
The influential Guy Stevens was brought in to work alongside Blackwell as a producer to emerging artists.
High energy, blazing star of a guy he was.
Guy was probably the most talented person I've ever come across in the music business.
The company was fast earning a reputation for having its finger on the pulse of the current underground music scene.
People wanted to work at Island. They wanted to be part of Island. They wanted to record for Island, or they wanted to get a job at Island.
We did kind of have a sort of a revolutionary zeal and fervor about what we were trying to do. We were taking on the majors.
A culture of signing new bands ensued. All joining the label were Spooky Tooth, Mott the Hoople, and